Good afternoon, everyone. Today I am taking the another topic for the lecture, that is socialism. The socialism is a kind of economy where everything is being governed by the government. Some of the economy like China, Cuba, South Korea, they are having a socialism kind of economy where everything, the working, the policies and everything is being made by the government. So here in this case, basically let's first focus on the features of socialism. First is public ownership. Here public ownership means that everything, whatever the working, whatever the rules, regulation, everything is being made, that will be done by the government only. And here the public, the ownership of each and every work will be through public. Next, central planning. Here the planning is being made with the help of the government only. The rules, regulation, the policies, economic policies are being made by the states, that is called as government. And here everything is being centralized because here the ownership is in the hand of government. Next, definite objectives. Yes, definitely when the government is being involved, they have a specific objectives that are predefined by them to make sure that people are so that it will be beneficial for the people who are there in the economy. So the objective can be full employment, less inflation, then social welfare activities, then economic growth. These can be the defined objective. Next, social welfare. As it is governed by the government, so the main motto of the government is to do the social welfare of the people, and for that they are making the programs, policies to make sure that the people who are living in that country will be socially benefited by them. Next, absence of competition. Definitely if there is the things are being governed by the government only, then there will be no competition. Then equality of income distribution. Equality of income distribution means that everyone who is there in the economy will be given equal income. It means that here the richer will not become richer, the poorer will not become poorer. Means the money will be taken from the rich people and they will be given in the form of welfare activities to the poor people, so that there will be an equal distribution of income at all the levels. Then planning and the pricing process. Definitely here they are going to plan how the working will be done in the economy, how the policies will be made, how its administration will be done, how the implementation will be done, and secondly the pricing. Here the government is trying to make a such pricing that they can earn the profit, as well as that pricing will not be affecting the customers also, because the main motto of the economy is to have a good relationship with the customers, and they also want a profitability situation. The next thing over here that we'll be focusing, that will be merits of socialism. What are the positive points that a socialist economy is having? First, greater economic efficiency. Yes, definitely government know how much resources are being available with them, how to use them, where to use them, in which sector it is being needed. So if all these things are well known and predefined, so definitely it will be easier for the government to do the work properly. The next is greater welfare due to the less inequality of income. Definitely if everyone, see in our India what we are having an unequal distribution of income. Means here the poor people are becoming more poor and richer are becoming more richer. But if the socialism kind of economy where there is less inequality, I'm not saying there will be an equality of income at one go, but they are trying to minimize the inequality. So if the people are having less inequality, the welfare programs will be easily adaptable, plus economic growth will be there, because at that point of time everyone will be earning by and large the same income, which is contributing to the GDP and which is contributing to the higher growth and the development of the economy. Next is absence of monopolistic practices. Monopolistic is basically an economy where there are large numbers of sellers in the market. They are going to sell their products in different prices. But here, as you know that it is being governed by the government, so there will be only the public enterprises who are going to sell the goods at one cost, and because of that, the monopolistic and the, you can say, adulterated practices and everything, which is the demerits of the monopolistic activities, that will not be there in the economy. Absence of business fluctuation. See, I'll not say that there will be a complete absence of the business fluctuations. Definitely there will be an ups and downs in the business which is being taken up by the government, but here if there is a government support, definitely the the downfall which is going to happen, that will going to happen in a very less case. Reason being, because government know how to make a settlement if they are facing the losses. Then sustainable economic growth. Sustainable means that it's not only focusing on the business growth, but it is also being focusing on the different areas like they are focusing on the customers, they are focusing on the employees, they are also focusing on the on their employees who are working there. So they are doing the overall growth, and here it's definitely, if the overall growth will be there, then the economic development will be in the more faster pace. Now let's move ahead with the demerit of socialism. Demerit of socialism, the biggest demerit is the loss of consumer sovereignty. Lack of consumer sovereignty means that here the consumer don't have the power to decide that how to spend their money. It means that whatever is being provided by the government, they have to use that thing. They don't have any freedom to consume as per their requirement or as per their wish. Next is your no freedom of occupation. Here basically there is, you can say that whatever is job provided by the state, the society has to take up that only. There should not be anything that they are they can choose for their own things, because here everything is governed by the government. You cannot make any of the business of your own. You have to work on the business which are being supported by the government. Misallocation of the resources might be possible. The government are doing the misallocation of the resources. How? Lack of incentive and initiative. Definitely in a government setup, you can also see that whenever they talk about incentive, it will be a group incentive, whether the work is being done by one person or whether it is done by the whole group. Everyone is given the incentive. So because of this, the people motive towards doing the better work will be less, plus they will not take the initiative while doing the work, because they know that taking the initiative also will not give them any benefits. Next, there is efficiency and low productivity. Definitely, if there is lack of incentive, lack of initiative, the people will not work as they can work over here. And definitely, it is going to affect the productivity of the work, because the people, if they are working for themselves, they are going to produce more, they are going to do the work in efficient manner. Plus, whenever they are not being given better incentives, they are not going to perform their work properly. Corruption, everyone know that in the bureaucratic kind of society, for doing a single work, we are requiring the people are requiring the money. So you can see an Indian setup also, wherever it is being governed by the government, there is corruption and people are accepting that because they have to do their work. Then there is concentration of economic power and state. Basically, in this condition, what is the thing? That everything is in the hand of the states. It is in the hands of government. Local people are having. So because of that, if the government is having everything, there will be the lack of work will be there, and the people will not perform their work properly. So with this, I am closing up my topic with the socialism. In the next topic, we will be covering the mixed economy kind of nature, where our Indian economy is having that. Okay, thank you very much.